Good morning, student. Myself, Professor Gada Keses from S&T College of Engineering and Research Center, EULA. So, student, we are learning the final year subject, that is the solar and wind energy. So, from that subject, from unit number 4, that is the case study on the solar energy application, we have seen some topics. All of you remember that? So, let's see which topics we have seen. From the unit number 4, we have to learn all 3 case studies. That is, first case study on the solar food dryer. Second case study, we have to learn on the parabolic dish solar cooker. And third case study, we have to learn on the photovoltaic system. All of you understand that? Out of that, first case study, we are seeing. So, let's see. From first case study, that is the solar food dryer, some topic we have covered: basics of solar dryer, basic principle of solar dryer, use of the solar dryers, and types of the solar dryers. Out of the 3 types, first type we have seen in the last lecture, that is natural convection solar dryer. In the today's topic, we are going to see the next topic, that is the remaining 2 types of the solar dryers. So let's see which are the remaining. So here is a classification. I have explained that classification in the last lecture also. If you don't watch that video, you can see that video, so you will understand the detailed classification of solar dryer. Out of that detailed classification, we have to see the 3 types of dryer: natural convection dryer, forced convection dryer, and tunnel dryer. Out of that, first dryer we have seen in the last lecture, and in the today's lecture we are going to see the forced convection dryers and tunnel dryers. So let's understand what is the tunnel dryers. So as per the name, tunnel dryer means what? The shape of the dryer is like the tunnel. So what they have said about the tunnel dryer: the structure of the tunnel dryer is relatively simple. The basic design components of the tunnel dryers are as a follows. So which are the design components are there? A semi-circular shaped solar tunnel in the form of polyhouse form structure with UV stabilized polythene sheet. That means that is nothing but the polyhouse. All of you understand? Tunnel dryer is nothing but the polyhouse. So the structure is in contrast to the other dryer design large enough for a person to enter. That means in the dryer, person also go and come outside. That means if you see in the polyhouse also, temperature is higher than the normal temperature, or we can maintain the temperature lower than the normal temperature. All of you understand? So that is nothing but the tunnel dryers. So second dryer we have to focus, that is nothing but the forced convection solar dryer. So let's see what is the forced convection solar dryer. As per the name, so forced convection, that means the air in the natural convection, what we have seen, we have used the naturally heated air for the drying purpose. But as per the name, forced convection solar dryer, here we have to forcefully convert heat the air, and that air we have to use for the drying purpose. So let's see what is the forced convection solar dryer. The convection is forced over the food through the use of the fan. That means for flowing the hot air, we have used the fan. You will see that also through the video, so you will get the detail idea. But let's understand the basics of that forced convection solar dryer. In the case of the forced convection dryer, the structure can be relatively similar. That means convection natural and forced convection structure will be similar. However, forced convection dryer require a power source for the fans to provide the air flow. For drying the fan, we require the power supply, but in the natural convection, we don't require the power supply. The forced convection dryer doesn't require an incline the airflow. However, the collector can be placed horizontally with the fan at one end and the drying bean at the other end. In addition, the forced convection dryer is less dependent on the solar energy as it provides the airflow itself. Fan itself provides the air. This allows the design to work in the weather condition in which the natural convection rarely doesn't work. That means in the weather condition, hot air naturally doesn't available. So we have to use the forced convection dry. As inadequate ventilation is a primary cause of the loss of food in the solar food dry and is made worse by the intermittent heat. It is essential to release the proper ventilation. Adding a forced convection flow, for instance, provided through a PV solar cell connect to the fan, will prevent the loss of the food. That means in the weather condition, naturally heated air is not available. That means natural convection is not possible. So in that situation, we have to use the forced convection solar dryers. So to prevent the loss of the food. All of you understand? So we are going to see that forced convection solar dryer through the video. So you will get the practical idea about that solar food dryer. So let's see the video related to the forced convection solar dryer.
Thank you.